Hi and welcome to the Stipulism tutorial. I'm Alice and in this episode I'll cover how to create and use multiple symbols. Overall we'll cover how to create multiple symbols, how to use multiple symbols in our stipple, and symbol identifiers. We've only ever used one symbol. What this setting does is allow you to use more. In order to use multiple symbols, we need to make them in a certain way. I'll use this photo of a rabbit. Okay, so firstly, I need to decide what I want to use as my symbols. In this case, I want to create a kind of crosshatch effect. So I'm going to draw two lines in opposing directions. At this point, I need to decide which of these I want to use as my base symbol, which will be my point of reference in the stipple menu. So I'm going to pick this one and drag it to the symbol panel, give it a clear name. After making my base symbol, I now need to decide my variants. Variants being the other symbols we want to use in the stipple at the same time. In this case, I just want one variant. So if I select my other stroke, and then we need to go to the object menu and click create symbol variants. A dialog box will open asking you which symbol you want to use as your base. Essentially, you are attaching these additional symbols to your base. And also there's an option to delete the object after this is completed. I'll tick that as it will be safely stored in my symbol panel. Press OK. And there we go, it's added our variant to our panel. The way this works is it creates a variant by adding a suffix to the end of the base file name. So the base is crosshatch and the variant is crosshatch underscore var, the variant, underscore 001. So if you wanted to, you could manually attach this name ending to any of the symbols rather than go through the object menu, making sure you increment the number at the end of the file name. There is no limit to how many symbols you want to use as variants. So let's put this to use. Apply our symbol stipple. And you'll see that now include variants is automatically selected when I choose the crosshatch base symbol. It even tells me that I have one variant. And let's press preview and change the settings till I'm happy with the result. In this case, it's made a really graphic effect. I can also use the sample color option in the same way. Again, a completely different effect, but extremely effective and quick. Let's have a look at another example. Here I've got various shades of fill for a simple triangle. I have my base triangle and the rest are set as variants. I can add to these in the same way. So select the new addition, go to Object, Create Symbol Variants, and it will automatically add it to my symbol variants. In order to update stipple to include my new variants, just toggle the effect in the Appearance panel. This coupled with the Rotation Follows Path setting creates a pretty convincing diamond. Lastly, let's cover symbol identifiers. Sounds complicated, but is incredibly simple. I can use the additional file ending to the name of my symbol in order to put settings on individual symbol variants. I say variants because you can't apply this to the base symbol. There's three altogether. The first equals U, meaning the symbol will only appear once in our stipple. Great for things like our moon here. Equals NS, meaning no scale, and equals NR, meaning no rotate, all of which I've used for my white elephant, which appears only once and ignores the scale and rotation settings applied to the rest of the stipple. You can use them separately or together, like I have with my elephant. We've reached the end of this tutorial. Just to recap, we've covered how to create multiple symbols, how to use multiple symbols in your stipple, and symbol identifiers. Congratulations, you've completed all our basic stippleism tutorials and are officially an expert. Do check out our webinars and Q&As for even more info. And don't forget, you can download our free 14-day trial today and see what you're inspired to create. Thanks for watching.